Welcome! My name is Rune Synnevåg and I'm VP of Technology here in Signicat. In this video, we're going to learn about how to connect to the Authentication API using OIDC. We will start by going to the developer dashboard and create an OIDC client. So let's get it started. You can see here I'm on my account and I will click API clients here to create a new OIDC client. Above me here, you can see the different endpoints you use for test and production for OIDC. You can click on the test endpoint and you get to the opening page here. You click the discovery endpoint and then you get every URL and information you need about the OIDC endpoint. So to shares, claim supported, grant type supported, response types, and keys. You see here that we support most different response types and response modes. But let's start creating a client. So I will click create new client here. I will give this client a name. And we will use authorization code flow. I'll click create and I get a client. Then we probably want to set some scopes and a URL. I will test using a demo site here, OpenID debugger. So I added the authorization URL here, and I'm going to need to add this redirect URL to our client. So I clicked here on config, click edit, and then add my redirect URL. I also want to add the profile scopes here, in addition to the OpenID scope. And click save. So now I got the profile scope added to my client. Now we can test this client. So I need to take the client ID, copy that, and add it into this tool here. And then we click send request. Here you can see bank ID and SMS OTP for login. Now let's try to add some flavor to this client. We will add a logo and some color. So let's go back here, back into the dashboard. I'll add some color codes here, primary color of blue, secondary color of red, and also let's add a logo. So since we're Signicat, we're going to go for a cat logo. We only need to add a URL here. Now you can see the logo. Let's try to logging in again. Now you can see we have a blue top bar here with a logo. So this is how you can customize your client. Now let's jump back into common questions asked when using OIDC. How can I pre-select a single IDP when using OIDC? As you saw from our demo, we could use both BankID, BankID Mobile and SMS OTP to log in. But what if I didn't want to use SMS OTP, only BankID? How could I pre-select that? Well, in OIDC, there's something called ACI values. You can add to your ACI values claim allowed IDPs and select the IDPs that you want to use. You just separate them with a comma. Read more about this in our documentation. How can I choose what IDPs are available for a single OIDC client? You can set that in the dashboard. I'll show you how to set that for our client now. So you can go in here to OpenID config, click edit, and then you set the restrictions here. So I set BankID and BankID Mobile. Click save, and then let's try to log in again. Now you can see we don't only have BankID here, not SMS OTP. So this is how you can set on a single client what kind of IDP you want to use. You can set it either on the client or using ACR values. Can I customize the OIDC using a logo, color, or title? This can be done in the developer dashboard as you saw in my demo. You can set the logo and the in the top, and you can also set primary colors. If you don't set the logo, you can set the title, that is the name of the client that is used. Is national identifier number sent in the ID token or the user info endpoint? This usually comes in the user info endpoint. But remember, you need to add NIN scope to your client in order to be able to retrieve it in the response. Also, not every IDP allow you to get the NIN from them without applying in advance. And there's some rules and regulations that are governing this, and you have to check that out per country. You can also opt in to allow it in the ID token, and there are specific use cases for this. This you can do in the developer dashboard by setting allow user always to include user claims in ID token. But remember, you don't want to do this unless you have to. Can I use OIDC with iframe? No, you cannot use it with iframe. Then you have to use the REST API. OIDC have no mechanism for setting, for example, content security policy and iframe headers. So you need to use the REST API for that. If you have any questions or comments, please let us know in the community or in the comments below. Thanks for watching and bye.